Hello, and welcome to TI Precision Labs. USB is a widely adopted interface for data and power transfer that has evolved over the last two decades. The introduction of USB 3 allows data rates up to 10 gigabits per second, more than 20 times the maximum of USB 2. Establishing a connection at this speed requires a different enumeration process that is defined in the USB 3.1 state machine. This presentation will explain how USB 3.1 connections are established between a host and a device. The USB 3.1 enumeration process is useful to know if you are designing or debugging a USB 3.1 system. The USB 3.1 specification defines two different connection speeds: super speed, which supports data rates up to 5 gigabits per second, and super speed plus, which supports up to 10 gigabits per second. Any USB 3.1 connection will be limited to the highest common speed supported by both the USB host and USB device. This means a 5 gig USB host will always establish 5 gig USB 3 connections, regardless of the device speed. The same is true for 5 gig USB devices. A 10 gig super speed plus connection is only possible when both the host and device support super speed plus data rates. The USB 3.1 enumeration process is defined by the USB state machine. We will focus on four key steps to understand how a USB 3.1 host and device establish a connection at 5 gig and 10 gig speeds. The first stage in USB 3.1 enumeration is RX detect. This state begins when you power on the USB host and device, but a connection has not yet been established. The USB host will periodically send a pulse-like signal on its transmitter to detect terminations from a connected device. These terminations are located on the device's receiver and will alter the RX detect pulse so the host knows that a device is present. While this is happening, the device will similarly send RX detect pulses on its transmitter to the host receiver. When both terminations are successfully detected, both the host and device transition to the polling state. Polling is the second state in the enumeration process. It begins with the low frequency periodic signal handshake, or LFPS for short. This is where the USB host and device ports send LFPS pulses to each other. These pulses communicate the speed that each port is capable of, whether that is 5 gig or 10 gig. If one port is capable of 10 gigabits per second, but the other is only capable of 5 gigabits per second, the 10 gig port will switch to 5 gig signaling during this handshake process. If both ports are capable of 10 gig data rates, they will transmit two signals called SCD1 and SCD2 to confirm a 10 gig connection is viable. Once the operation speed is determined, both ports will enter the training stage. Training is the final stage of polling that transitions the USB connection into the active state. It begins with both ports sending ordered sets called TSEQ to each other. These are combinations of symbols that ensure the link between host and device is stable. Once 65,536 consecutive TSEQ sets have been received, the ports will send a new ordered set known as TS1. TS1 only needs to be received 8 times before the next ordered set, TS2, is sent. We can think of TS2 as an acknowledgement that TS1 was received. When 8 sets of TS2 are received, the USB3 link transitions to an idle state just before U0 is entered. In this state, both ports will send idle symbols to each other, and after 8 consecutive symbols are received, the link transitions to U0. U0 is the active state of a USB3 connection, where data transfer between the host and device takes place. This is how a USB3 flash drive, capture card, or webcam communicates with an attached computer. In a working system, U0 will persist until the interface is brought to a low power mode or is interrupted by disconnecting the USB. Here is a summary of the USB 3.1 enumeration process. These 4 steps will govern whether the USB 3 connection is established correctly or whether the link falls back to USB 2 speeds. Here is a quick quiz to test your knowledge of the USB 3.1 enumeration process. First, RX detect is the second step in USB 3.1 enumeration. This is false. RX detect is the first step in the USB enumeration process. 2. 8 pairs of TS1 and 8 pairs of TS2 must be detected to complete the training stage. This is true. 3. Superspeed Plus is another term for a 10 gigabits per second USB 3.1 connection. This is also true. 4. A 10 gigabits per second USB host and a 5 gigabit per second USB device can establish a 10 gigabit per second USB connection. This is false. In this scenario, the connection speed would be limited to 5 gigabits per second because that is the highest speed the USB device can support. That concludes this overview of the USB 3 enumeration process. You can find more information about the USB products TI offers on the interface overview page linked in the slide shown. Thanks.